3:4-5. Would you please say amen?
Amen.
He is despised and rejected of men, a man of sorrow and acquainted with grief, and we hid as it were our faces from him. He was despised and we esteemed him not. Surely he has borne our grief and carried our sorrow. Yet we did esteem him stricken and smitten of God and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgression. He was bruised for our iniquity. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. Acts chapter 2, verse number 36. Therefore, let all the house of Israel know assuredly that God has made that same Jesus, whom you crucified, both Lord and Christ. Our topic for this morning is that same Jesus. Just turn to your neighbor and say, that same Jesus. Let's look to the Lord. Father, we are looking to you, the author and the finisher of our faith. We thank you for the opportunity to come this morning to bring your word. Help it to be in my meaning in all things. Take me behind the veil that you may prevail in this place. And we will be mindful to give you all the glory and the honor. Let's do your name. Put your hands together and give God some glory. You may be seated in Jesus' name. The same Jesus. This Jesus, Webster defined, same as, there is no difference. But Jesus, as he was working in time past, still works today.
Yes.
And he has the power to bind and to loose whatever you're going through.
Yes.
I know that there are many needs that are in this place. We're not going to talk about the land. We're going to talk about right here in this place.
Right.
Hallelujah. That God is saying to us that he is the same yesterday, today, and forever. That you can come to him. And Isaiah 55 says, you don't have to have no money. Come without price. Come. Just come to him. Come to the throne boldly.
Right.
That you may be able to find help in the time of need.
Right.
And the time that is of our need is right now. Somebody say right now.
Right.
We need a right now God to move in a right now situation. Hallelujah. We need God to move in the doctor's place. Move. We need God to move in the psychiatrist's place. Move. We need God to move in the husband and wife's place. Move. We need God to move in the children's place. Move. Somebody say, move, Jesus.
Move, Jesus.
Oh, glory to God. Jesus suffered the death, praise God, in the burial. Hallelujah. As he was going up, God got the healer. And the opportunity over in Jerusalem to walk up that hill. When I got about halfway there, I was ready to exchange my insurance in and tell him I want to go back home to Texas and turn this in because it was so hard to walk up the hill. And I could imagine my Lord and our Savior walking up the hill, hallelujah, with the cross on his back. But I want you to know it was for you and I. Because he knew that we were going to deal with some stuff right down here. He knew, praise God, that that was going to be some things, praise God, that will make you weak in the midnight hour. He knew there was going to be some pain, praise God, that bring tears down your eyes, praise God, and help you call on the name of Jesus. So he said, I was wounded for your transgression. Hallelujah, bruise. That bruise means that I took a beating. Hallelujah, that he took such a beating that as they beat him, hallelujah, the flesh was poor from his body. So whatever you're going through today, that is nothing too hard for God. That you can come to him. Hallelujah. And he is able to fix whatever the problem is. Hallelujah. He can show up and show out in your situation. I know many of you are confronted with some situation beyond your control. You need to be a doctor in a hospital even right now. You need to be a want to forget about the Lord, the healer that the cows are offering. The same Jesus. He comes to let us know, praise God. Hallelujah, Christian. Hallelujah. Who is your part? Will you believe? Will you believe by the part of the Lord? Or will you, hallelujah, walk around with your head all hanging down? Wondering, Lord, how? Praise God, when? Will you deliver? Anytime you have a ride, you need to just start looking. How, Lord? How are you going to work it out? Don't be worried about how he's going to do it. Just know that he's going to do it. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, because we have a lot of lives. Why, Lord, why do I have to go through this? Why, Lord, hallelujah, why did I lose my job? Why, Lord, why did I get this happen to me? Hallelujah, but why not you? Hallelujah. And we understand the God that we serve, that hallelujah, he will pay the price, and that price was his precious blood. Hallelujah, the blood of Calvary's cross, that he comes to let us know. Praise God, hallelujah. Don't think you can do what you want to do, if you want to do it, or how you want to do it. Hallelujah, God will let you know real quickly. You're not in control of anything. He's in control of everything. And therefore, you got to lean and depend on him. You got to trust him in his better words. If he says he's going to bring you out, if you're in the middle of a situation, and it looks very dead, and it looks like he's not going to come out, I dare you to get him in that place with God. It's for pass. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The things that you're going through is going to make you. Hallelujah. If it had not been for the shaking, hallelujah, that would be the making. Hallelujah. If it had not been for you going through some things, praise God. I'm talking about suffering. You have to be poor. Somebody said, but it won't kill you, it'll definitely make you. Hallelujah. It'll make you stronger in the Lord. It'll make you, hallelujah, stand up. Hallelujah, and be a good soldier. It'll make you grab a hold of the power and not look back, praise God. Hallelujah, we're living in a time, praise God. Hallelujah, but the enemy, hallelujah, is fixing everything up. Hallelujah, and calling wrong right, and right and wrong, and good, bad, and bad, good. Hallelujah, in a time that people are confused about what is really right. Oh, glory to God, I feel the Holy Ghost in this place. Hallelujah. On these college campuses, praise God. There's so much going on now. They got a big praise God. They call the Lord when you're on earth. It's an earth, it's a therapy. We find it in the name of Jesus. It's a little time here, but I know God is speaking. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You have no right. The judgment is on young people. The Lord said the judgment is on young people because you believe in a generation that will worship the Lord our God. And hallelujah, worship at his holy place. Hallelujah. That the Spirit of God will raise up people. Hallelujah. That hallelujah will honor him and serve him.
Hey, glory.
Those that have children, you better wake up. Yes. And realize it's high time to be about our Father's business. To realize that the same Jesus has not changed. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. Hallelujah. God is sounding me a trumpet in Zion. He's sounding real loud on the college campus. He's sounding real loud in the schoolhouses. Letting us know. Wake up. Because in the last days, disobedience will be on the uprise. We've seen so many children disobedient. Rebellious. Hallelujah. And we wonder, Lord, what is happening? What is going on? Hallelujah. But I feel a shaking in the earth. God is getting ready to move. And I'm prophesying to you today. Glory to God. If you don't get yourself together, hallelujah, glory to God. Hallelujah, you're going to find yourself in a position, praise God. Hallelujah, glory to God. That you're going to be wondering, well, how? How do God in myself in the place. Jesus is the same God. He said, come unto me.
Yes.
All ye that are labored and heavy laden.
Yes.
And I will give you rest.
Yes.
But glory to God. For the mothers that are visiting the prisons. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Try to find peace. But he said, he is our peace.
Yes.
He's the Prince of Peace. But we must wake up and realize that the God we serve, hallelujah, is able. He is speaking to all the people, speaking to young people. I was at the beauty shop two months ago, hallelujah, and one of the ladies that was doing other people's hair, she said, I came out the club running because I saw this old grandma with some water legs. Wake up! The time is near. It's high time to be about our Father business. When we got kids who committed suicide, a temple, here he is. Our psychiatrist is running over. Can't even hold it, he can't be. Because people are troubled in their mind. But we have to make up our minds today. Are we going to be saved? Are we going to trust the same God that said, I'll be with you? The waters won't overtake you. Hallelujah. The floods won't draw you in. I'll be there in the midnight hour. I'll be there when the storms are rising. Hallelujah. I'll be there when you can't see your way through. Hallelujah. I will be there. Oh, yes, it will. Yes, it will be right there to see you through. See you through the dark days, the dark times of your life. Hallelujah. Because there's a times that some people are going through right now. And you wonder, hallelujah, I come into church, I put on my smile on the face, I shout, hallelujah, but deep down on the inside, there is a dead man spirit. Lord, what is really going on? When you church, you're one way. When you're at home, hallelujah, it's like, hallelujah, Freddy Krueger has broken out. God has said, wake up. The Son of Jesus is time to take authority over our home. Hallelujah. Take authority. The enemy will not prevail. Stronghold. Everything that the enemy put before you, you can claim it, hallelujah, and say, you're coming back today. You're coming back. Don't get intimidated. Don't get fearful. When you see the enemy as it is, you're coming out and say, you're coming out. You're coming out in the name of Jesus. You will be set free. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. As it speaks expressively. Let us know that you are here today to hear the Son of Jesus. You don't even have to work. And if the women, the worldly women, it is time to call a fast and prayer. Fasting and praying move God. If we want to see a difference, we want to see a change, we're going to have to get before God and ask God, move, Lord. They are spending billions of dollars in the White House trying to figure it out, and God has already given us the plan. He's already told us that he will bind loose and he will bind up the wounds. Heal the broken heart. Set the captive free. What are we going to do? What are we going to do about this situation? What are we going to do about abuse? Not only are the females being abused, men are being abused as well. Demonic forces just being released. People doing all kinds of things. But the word of God declares it. He said, in the last day, we are in perilous time. Perilous time. Perilous means evil. But people are fainting. Fainting over the little smallest thing. Fainting because they lose a job. Fainting because somebody cursed them out. Fainting because somebody took their parking spot over the little smallest thing. Perilous time. And these little cute darlings that you're dressing up, and you put these little ruffles around them, and you're not teaching them about God, and you put them in anybody's lap, and let anybody keep them, and they looking after them, for the final report.
Yes.
Oh, that's why we believe in your children.
Yes.
Even when they come home, and even when you're signing them up for child care, you need to find out your YouTube background check. What are you putting in here to see about my children? Yes. When people are walking in, sometimes they'll walk in the daycare and say, I don't even want to see the place, I'm just ready. I said, no, I must take you around and tell you a little bit about it. And I need you to bring your child, because in this day and time, I want to know what I'm dealing with. They come in and say, I just need the application, and I just need to sign my child. No, I need you to bring your child in the business, because I want to see what's coming in here.
Yes.
Glory to God.
Yes.
We need to wake up.
Yes.
Wake up out of sleep and realize that it's high time in the Lord to be about our Father's business.
Yes.
And we need to know that God said, I'll be with you in the midnight hour. We are in midnight. The sun is going down. The sun is going down. If you can't tell, the Bible says that you can tell the signs, the times of all these things, but you can't tell the ending of time. Hallelujah. But you can't tell by the things that are going on that the end is near. And it's so good to send our children to college. It's wonderful. But let me tell you, they got more on these college campuses than you would ever imagine. Jesus. I don't worry about the looks. Because let me tell you, as Jeremiah was preaching, they put him in human ways. As Stephen was preaching, they stoned him to death. As Jesus was going up to him. It's something to have people that honor you. He came in with a triumphant, and they had the palm trees, Hosanna in the house. Right. Later on, they said, crucify him.
Yeah.
To be a preacher, you will be crucified. If you are a true preacher, you are going to be crucified. You better be ready to die in this flesh. Amen. We'll give it all up for Jesus. Amen. That you can walk in power and authority. But none of these things move me. Amen. It's time to be saved. And set free. Amen. I know this is not a short message, but your ears are attentive to God's word, and I appreciate the Lord for that. Amen. But you are hearing what the Spirit is saying unto the church.
Yes.
And is speaking expressively. Letting us know that it is time. Will you stand to your feet?
Oh, hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Oh, glory to God. In the name of Jesus. Just close your eyes if you come. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.